Good evening. I'm Nicholas Hoare for Vermont PBS. Over the 40-odd years of the family firm's existence, we have sold 80% of our books to libraries and 20% to our retail customers. It is the libraries that, oddly enough, are of interest today. We have, over the years, collected a wonderful array of well-meant typos, which are absolutely delightful and which have stood the test of time. We've used them on the odd occasion socially and at library convention meetings and that sort of thing, but I've never used them privately. And I thought, to mark the occasion of April Fool's Day, that we would play a bit of a joke on you. And if you'll forgive us, we're not going to talk about a book, we're going to talk about several. And these are the sort of things that we've amassed over the four decades we've been at it. There was an order that came in from Ontario, which read 1984 by George Drivel. There was Stephen Fischinksy's In Praise of Old Women. There was a book by a man called Lenny Hatfield, which should have read Great Fun with Organs, but it came out as Great Fun with Organists. You can see where I'm heading. There's Wives, Beers, and Spirits. There's the Drab Israeli Wars. Understanding and Gilding Young Children. Excuse me. And then one of the best, which is the United Arab Emigrates. A Modern History. We had Who's Who in Canadian Jewry, which came out as Who's Who in Canadian Jewelry. We had, instead of Little Gloria Happy at Last, which was Gloria Vanderbilt, it came out as Little Gloria Hippie at Last, and it was ordered in the month of January. We had the Shetland Sheepdog. We had a book called Adolf Hitler by a gentleman called Mein Kampf. And we had the Clear and Pimple Thesaurus. Which might explain a lot. However, youth, the years from 10 to 16, came out from a Lethbridge library as Youth, the Yearns from 10 to 16. Then we had the old lady who was referred to us by an extremely erudite Montreal library with a note attached saying, she requires love letters, needed somewhat urgently, time is running a bit short. Oh dear, oh dear, excuse me, but you can see these are absolute classics. Then we have the book which was called The 101 Dalmatians, written by Dopey Smith, to which my staff editor added in a moment of levity, I always thought this was a daft story and now I know why. Oh joy, oh joy. We had Donna Washburn, More of Canada's Best Bread Machine Banking Recipes. I've always wondered how to work ATMs. Oh dear. Then we have the rather apologetic note from the North Hatley Library in Quebec saying, Jeffrey Archer, a matter of honor. The dog has chewed it, but part of the book number is 6348. Oh dear, I shouldn't be recording this nonsense. However, it's all great fun. We have a library in the Great North who sent us a note saying, please send the following books in hardback. Where paperbacks are specified, do not send unless they're at least 5 inches wide and at least 7 inches high. So useful. And we had Everyday Life in Medieval Tombs. If only I could quilt, recovering from nicotine addiction. And speaking of quilts, prize country gilts, which is a classic. Arthur Ransom Swallowable. And Helen McInnes's Snare of the Hunter, which came out as Helen McInnes Snore of the Hunter. Paul Sindel, I Never Loved Your Mind, which incidentally was an excellent book for teens, came out unfortunately as I Never Loved Your Mink. We have Paul Reverse's Ride. And we have that wonderful book by Victor Levy Beaulieu called Don Quixote in Nighttown, which came out as Don Quixote in a Nightgown. We have the check which we sent for deposit to the Bank of Montreal, which was mysteriously bounced. And that read Nicholas Hoare, with that spelling. There it is. Oh, dear. We have no more hot flashes by one penny butt off. It should have been, of course, bud off. And we have All Quiet on the Western Front, which came out as All Quit on the Orient Express. Somehow we managed to locate it. One of my favorites, though, was a dear gentleman called Peter Smith, who is a reprint, or was, a reprint house of great stature in Magnolia, Massachusetts. And we had written saying, we have no record of the book you've sent it. We have no order for it. Would you be very kind to send us a copy and we'll fulfill it? To which he writes back, cannot send your original order slip. Once we fill an order, we discard the original and the invoice remains our only record. Your order slip is resting comfortably under tons of rubbish at our public dump. To avoid pollution of the atmosphere, the Massachusetts legislature have enacted a law which makes it a penalty to burn rubbish in an open container. It all goes to the dump now, and by the end of the year, the latter will be so full our homes will have to be demolished to make way for an extension. However, it is still legal for public utilities, oil and gas refineries to burn and pollute. They promise to rectify matters in about 5 years. We'll all be suffocated by that time. We are a wacky people. Signed, Peter Smith. Oh, dear. Then there was the unfortunate typo of a book called No Night Is Too Long by the wonderful mystery writer Barbara Vine. But unfortunately, it came out as No Night, spelled K-N-I-G-H-T. Oh, joy, oh, bliss. Then we have Anita Desai's Inheritance of Loss, which came out as Inheritance of Less. Excuse me, it's April 1st. We have Aldous Huxley's Eyeglass in Gaza. And we have Discovering the Pleasure Principle with the unfortunate subtitle of Feeling Up Naturally. We have the Adrian Mole Diaries, which came out as the Arabian Mole Diaries. And we have that wonderful typo, which came out as follows. Everybody knows about a Hasselblad camera, which is a wonderful thing. This came out as the Hasselbald Guide, to which our editor added, it always was a problem. And we have the Count of Monte Cristo. And then we have those wonderful typos, which I've collected, which were sent to us electronically. These ones, of course, came in writing on 3x5s. The boob that could lip read. And that famous order, which was dispatched to the School for Dead and Crippled Children. Very unfortunate and totally politically wrong. And finally, we have the classic of all. We got an order for 12 copies of Mastering the Fart of French Cooking, on which lunatic and very affectionate note, good evening.